Hey, two videos in 2 days. That's like a rarity for me, especially these days. No, there's a reason for that. This one here was interesting enough to me. I've said before, I like doing these video response videos. I don't know why. It's something about them I just like, even though I go on for too long. And this is my third time trying because I've gone on too long, and here I am doing it again. But saw Matt Metropolis. He did a video response to it, and probably wouldn't have known otherwise because, to be honest, this is someone new to me entirely, my long experience being on the site even before I did videos. No one I recognize, to be honest with you. But still, I thought, hey, new different questions I've seen somewhere, other things before, but I'm fine with that. There's 7 of them, not all game related, by the way, which is kind of nice to see that variety, although I kind of wish 2 wasn't here. You'll see why. I'm sure you can guess, and you won't be surprised once I do it. That's the one I gotta be careful with, how long it goes on for. But anyway, yeah, I just want to do it, why not, and my third time trying, so maybe I can get under the time I kept doing. Practice makes perfect, I guess. Anyway, there's some more house cleaning first before I start. As always, the same thing I say about these. In the description, I'll have a link to his channel as well as the original video. If you like the questions, which, by the way, I'll have all 7 in order in the description as well below those, so expand that. If you like the questions, he came up with them, not me. Give your answers on his video. Give him the views, give him the comments, and the quote of someone that does it as a running joke. It's annoying, but it's true. Comments are good for the YouTube algorithm. Do it on his thing so he can say it. I'm giving my answers in video form. All right? So go ahead. Go nuts with it. More the merrier. Anyway, so like I said, 7 of them, not all game related, some are. And yeah, I'll try to do my best with these and not go on for too long. And some of them, I am going to have to break the 90s theme, as you can see from the title. That's what the theme of it all is. So I'm going to have to break it slightly for a few things. But most of it, I can stick with the 90s as best as I can. Even when I did my own questions on here on Twitter, where I spend most of my days, even with my own stuff I do, I try to do that because it set a good example. Anyway, also, sorry about the glare. These aren't anti-glare lenses. I have to have my notes on the computer monitor or this will be really bad. Trust me. And I have some visual aids for some of the questions. All right, so let's get this going here, right? All right, so number one is favorite cartoon you own on DVD or favorite cartoon? Really, the answer for me is pretty much the same. I don't really bother with much cartoons these days anymore. I don't know. As an adult, I guess I have some kind of aversion to it. I don't know. But this one, there's some that kind of linger for me. And if there's any I wanted on video, I can still watch again. This was definitely a top one for me. I liked a lot. It started in the 80s, I know, but I watched it pretty much mostly in the 90s, so that's why I'm putting it here. It's also the only thing I could go with for this at all that I even have on video. And I don't have the whole thing. I saw a chance to get some of it, so I went for it. And that's The Real Ghostbusters. Liked a lot. In fact, I'm okay with not having the whole thing because earlier on it was better. Then once they started pimping Slimer more, kind of changed enough for the better. And I still liked it at then, but it wasn't as good. Alright, so the second one, this is the one I wish would just, you know, kind of slide away, fade away, not come up so much. Like, I understand. Alright, I understand why it's here. I understand why you did it. I understand why other people put it in. I'm just a little tired of it, and I'm tired of saying the same thing, and I'm tired of seeing the old bickering, because my answer for this is I don't change much as a person. I have the same thing about it back then as I did now when I was younger, and now when I'm older. I don't take sides, because there's no reason for it, especially with this stuff. It's annoying. It's childish, it's petty, it's petulant, it's annoying. The whole Sega versus Nintendo thing, and because it's the 90s, we're really talking about the Genesis, Mega Drive, Super Nintendo here. I had both back then. I have both now. Everything's way overpriced for the retro game thing. It's not getting any better. So there's no reason not to have both, or just friggin' emulate them, because, you know, there's really nothing to it. But I like both a lot, and I have both. I mean, technically I have more Genesis Mega Drives, but I just wanted all the different versions I could get, and I have the 2 add-ons for it, the 32X and Sega CD, whatever. I had the Super Game Boy again for the Super Nintendo, so I have something else for that too, but I like them both a lot. I couldn't choose then, I can't choose now, because I don't lock myself off from that. I go where the games are. That's the best way to be. My background, where I started, I'm saying all this because I know you haven't seen my stuff, so you wouldn't know this, of course, obviously. Others have been watching me for a time to hear this before, but still, bears repeating. My background I started with is computer games, and I still play games on the computer. That's what I started with, and old habits die hard. But the first console I ever had was the Super Nintendo, but 2 weeks later I got the Genesis Mega Drive. Now, I've said this before too, and I should explain it again, because I haven't said it on here in a while on like Twitter. As a company, especially the old one, more than the new one, but even then, to a degree, they're still like this. I always have and still find Sega to be more interesting. They took more risks. Nintendo always played it more safe. They still do even now. And far too many give Nintendo a slide on things they do bad. I don't give Sega a pass either, even though it seems like I favor them. I find them more interesting, so I talk about them more. I want to talk about more games on their platforms more, and I want to talk about their platforms more just because I find it to be more interesting to talk about. Doesn't mean I hate the Super Nintendo or anything like that. I like the thing a lot. I hate the Nintendo 64 controller, as I'm pretty well known at this point to have said, and I mean it. But I like the N64 a lot, many games on it. So even then, my favorite handheld is a Nintendo one. It's the Game Boy Micro, or I should say the Game Boy Advance, but I like the Micro version, which I have one, finally. I have a GameCube, and I have the Super Nintendo and the Super Game Boy player, but I also, for Sega, the only system of theirs I'm missing is the Master System, but the Genesis Micro, I could play that, so who cares? But my point is, I never took sides back then, and I still won't now, because I go where the games are. Why would I shut myself out of it? It's even just factoring in emulation, why? I can't do it. I couldn't do it then. Although, ironically, for the longest time now, things have changed. I can only find Super Nintendo games. It's kind of ironic when I actually want to find more for the Genesis Mega Drive, because, again, another example, even though I don't favor it, I kind of like collecting games for it more because, well, I can get them in the hard plastic box on, like, the cardboard ones, which are missing for the Super Nintendo for the most part, and they also cost more that way. That's the best way I can answer that, and I went on too long. Sorry. Say what I meant in the beginning? I knew it was going to happen, but that's the best answer I can have. I don't take sides with that. I still don't take sides now with this stuff. So, hey. It's not how I am. Never how I was. I didn't like it back then, and I still don't like it now. And it's... got tired of it years ago. That's all. Sorry. Maybe I'm a killjoy, but you hear about it and see it enough as I do. When you don't go looking for it, even, it wears on you. That's all. That's the problem. It's a me thing. Anyway, I understand why it's in here. Again, believe me, I get it. Alright, so let's move on. Number three. Oh, by the way, I'm using a Sega game for an example here, and there's a reason for that, too. Anyway, favorite console game. Now, just like I said, when I do my own thing, I want to stick to it as close as I can. So this is a game that was never an arcade game and was ported to it, even though the system is well known for having arcade ports. But this was always a console game, always console exclusive, and technically it still is, well, it was re-released on the Xbox 360, Xbox Live Arcade, digital only, but that's a console, so it's still console only. It's not even on Steam. Not that I remember. If it is, sorry, I can't memorize everything. Anyway, I've always only had, played, and preferred the original Saturn version, which I have it once again, like I did back then, although I have a Japanese version because it's the only way I can afford it. Again, just emulate it. It's a great game. Play it if you never have. I can't suggest it enough. It's my favorite Saturn game for a reason. So, some of you already know what it is. It's Guardian Heroes, yes. Fantastic beat-em-up by Treasure with RPG elements and many endings and payoffs and blah, blah, blah. It's great. I love it. It's fantastic. I got a paper crane in the box when it came in. It's, you know, can't beat that. Okay, so let's move on. Number four, favorite comic. I like this because comics don't really come up much in this kind of stuff, and I don't really get to talk about comics much. This is a little hard for me because I don't have any of my originals. I was originally going to just mention like what my favorite series is. Not my favorite character, but my favorite series, which is The Good Darkness. I have a good amount of it. Again, some of those are ones I had back then. It started in the 90s, but I can't find any more for it, which sucks. It was The Darkness, Moon Knight, X-Men, and Batman is what I was into, and foreshadowing with Batman. Batman's my favorite comic book character, period. So I had to kind of fudge this a little. It's not from the 90s. It's ASN to the 80s, so it's close enough, but it's an individual comic, and even with what I have now that I got back, and it is from, I couldn't tell you. So I thought this would be good because it's an individual one. It's all standalone, which I like too. And I actually have the deluxe version because I saw it for Jack Nuffin, and I went for it.
Ooh,
yeah. Many of you will notice because it's very famous, but hey, still a good example. And this is actually one of the very few times I've noticed it shows up on a camera, still a video. I think it's because, ironically, the glare from the monitor. But it's the Killing Joke, yes. Very good. Read it if you never have. Doesn't have to be this, could be whatever version. I don't know. Find someone who put it up as a video on YouTube. It's short, but it's really good. So I'm going to go with that. Came out in 1988 originally. That re-release happened sometime later. So that's the best I could do for that. Okay, so next up, this is a pretty easy one. I'm going to give you two. My real answer for it is skipping the 90s theme and what one from the 90s. And I'm not doing good on time. I'm trying to speed up. All right, so number five here is favorite pro wrestler. For me, my top one has always pretty much been Randy Macho Man Savage. I can do a pretty good impression on him too, but my voice has killed me today, so I'm not going to do that. So that's obviously not 90s. Now, for one for the 90s, and that's pretty much when I gave up with one of two, when the Attitude Era ended. Well, that was really early 2000s, but still. Kane, you know, when he used to have, he didn't talk and he had the red and black mask. It's pretty cool. It's one of the reasons I liked him. And I've been so far out of loop, but I found out he talks and he doesn't wear the mask anymore. So, whatever. But that's probably who I'd go with as my top favorite wrestler from the 90s, specifically, would be Kane. when he still had the mask on and he didn't talk. I thought that was kind of a cool gimmick. Anyway, so there's that one. Now, number six, I could do half this one. I'll explain why. Even then, when it came to the... Well, whatever. Number six is favorite song and music video. I could do the song part, and I'll do that now. My favorite song is not from the 90s. In fact, it takes me quite a few to before I get to the 90s, but I pretty much think it's this one. It's a Billy Joel song. Big fan of Billy Joel, actually. And it's also the title song of said album, so you might already know what it is. That is The River of Dreams. Yes, and the album for it. Although, I could also probably go with As Equal from the same album, even Lullaby, Goodnight, My Angel, which, funnily enough, those two songs actually have they're related, without going into it. I love music, have a ton of it, listen to it all the time, but a lot of the music, most of my favorites are actually sub-90s, and one's very, very pre-90s. It's a Beethoven song. But I'd probably go with River of Dreams. Now, music video, to be honest, it's much like number two. I don't change much, and as much music as I have, and I love, and I've always listened to, I don't care for music videos. I never have. In fact, most I probably should have seen long before now, including for songs I really like a lot. Never seen them until recent times. It's just how I am. I don't care about them. So I couldn't tell you what one I like most. And even then, the best example I can come up with is not from the 90s. And it's a very common one, but there's a reason for that, because a lot of effort went into it, and it's kind of like a mini horror movie. And that's, of course, Thriller from Michael Jackson. It's interesting. The song's really great, but so is the music video. That's not 90s, though, of course. And when it comes to the 90s, there's quite a lot of songs I like from the 90s. I can't think of a single one that has an interesting music video. Because they just really nothing interesting happens to them. I don't pay attention to them either, so hell if I know. Tell you plenty of songs I like from the 90s, can't tell you one I like a music video for. In fact, there's some where I've seen the music video. I really don't like the music video, but I still like the song a lot. I can't do it the other way around, though, where I can think of one where I like the music video, but I don't like the song. So I couldn't even do that for you. Sorry. I still like the question, though. It's not just favorite song, put another aspect to it. I like that. That's good. Alright, so this last one's easy, and I got too many visual aids, and I'm not holding up that big expensive box I have for it, although that would be impressive. I think I did a video for it anyway, I showed it. I know I showed it on Twitter once. Number seven, favorite live-action TV show and episode. Episode's a little hard, but I can explain it. I don't remember the exact title, although I'm way too much into the show, I should know. My favorite show, live-action show, is just my favorite TV show in general, is The X-Files. Always has been. Love it. Still watch it plenty now. I have the entire run. Big expensive box. I have both the movies. I have a big thick book about the show. I have quite a few things. I have the FMV game, the PlayStation. You know, I have a PlayStation 1 anymore, and I have the computer version. I love the show. Always have. Has a little bit of everything in it. It's one of the reasons I like it. But when it comes to favorite episode, I can't remember the exact title. The problem with the show is a lot of them have Latin names, and some of them I can pronounce, and I know specifically what they're called. This one I forget always. No, I know. It just came to me. Folly Adieu, and Mulder explains when he actually says it in the episode. Some of the episodes, titles never come up in the show. Anyway, it's the one, I can explain it even better than the title, why he came up with that name in it. Vinyl Right, it's people go postal because they're going psychotic because they're losing their friggin' mind because their boss, this fat chubby guy, Mark Pincus is his name in it. He's essentially a bug, but he hides in the light and he turns people into zombies, and only some people who... It's never explained, of course, it's just the way of the show, and it's part of the fun. But some people can notice and some people can't, how they're turned into this, and then eventually Mulder is one who does notice it, and he starts wigging out too, because he gets obsessed with trying to catch this chubby guy, and blah, blah, blah. And he's a big bug, and he's turned people into zombies, his drones, essentially. I could go on about this show forever, so I shouldn't, but... is why that I go with as my favorite episode, unlike some others that most others go with, like Postmodern, Prometheus, and many from Season 5, in fact. This one's from Season 4. In fact, I even remember the disc on it in Season 4. It has a picture from War of the Carthaginians as the image on the disc. But anyway, very short Season 4. If I'm wrong, then I'm really doing bad today. Anyway, I just something about it I always liked. It's an interesting episode in many ways. I'd have a hard time if you really... I had to choose what my absolute favorite is. I mean, it's probably the best candidate I have. Like, if I had five of them, that would probably be one of the top ones, which I can't remember seeing a lot others go with that one, which is kind of a shame, I think. There's a lot of clever ones in there, but there's some ones as well. But I'm going to go with that one. Folia de. Took me 3 attempts doing this video to try and do a shooter. I failed again, by the way. And I finally remembered the title without going to look. So there you go. Anyway, again, sorry for going on too long. It's just the way I am, especially for you, Bucky749. This is how I am. I'm sorry. But hopefully you've still liked my answers and found it interesting. And weren't put off by me not looking at the camera as much as I should have. I've always been bad with that, too. And I've been out of practice since I haven't done a lot of videos, but hey. I prefer being behind the camera than in front of it. I've always been better like that. I'm an honest person. Anyway, so there you go. Once again, I'll have links in the description to his original video. Do your answers there, not online. His channel, as well as the 7 questions in order in the description. Anyway, I'm going to end this now. Thanks for listening and watching, and I hope you liked it and I wasn't too annoying or boring. Adios.